Hello everyone, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today we will discuss the handwriting digit recognition. We use the neural network, and it's just like we have some digit using handwriting 1, 2, 3, 4 from 0 to 9, and we will use the Keras and TensorFlow to create the neural network. Okay, I have write using the Google Colab. Actually, the code is from the other side, HackerNoon, but I will add some Google Drive usage, how to save and upload an image using Google Colab, also Google Drive. So we will save our work in Google Drive. Okay, my Python program is MNIST, and this is the Google Colab. And this is for the files. So first we import the library, TensorFlow, Matplotlib, NumPy, and CV2. This is for image processing or presenting the image. So we need the data. The data come from the Keras dataset. So we will download this. For example, the image number 0, train image and train label. So this is the number five. This is the RGB. There is a lot of color here. And this is the summary, the random from 1 to 20. For example, this is 4, this is another 4, 9, 6, another 6, and etc. And then we check the number of the time data and test data. This is the standard format of TensorFlow. So there is a this is the number of object, and this is the width and height. This is the pixel 28 and similar with the test image. And then we normalize the data, divide by the maximum number is 255. So the data only contain 0 to 1. This is important because we use the ReLU activation. If we use sigmoid, maybe this is not a must. But if you use the ReLU, this is you should divide to maximum number. Okay, this is the neural network design. We use 1, 2 hidden layer, and there is a one input and one output. One output contain a 10 node, 10 neuron using a softmax. You can search in Google what is the softmax. This is actually a maximum, but there is a soft similar to probability. And we will see the summary of our network here. There is a flatten function from Keras. Flatten is create a matrix into vector. 28 by 28 is 2, 7, 8, 4 is for input. Array from matrix. And this is actually a softmax. This is a input, and this is the neural network, and the output is softmax. There is a 10 class. If the maximum number is in class 1, so the input predict 1. And then after creating the layer, we have to compile using optimizer Adam. And then and loss function is sparse categorical cross entropy. And the matrix is accuracy. And then we have to train using a 100 epoch. Epoch is similar with iteration, but there is a back or reverse. Iteration is only forward, but epoch is forward and backward. Okay, if you run this, there is a minute and a lot of time to train the network. So I want to only use my self train network here using the Google Drive. So I have to activate the Google Drive. Actually, if we don't have the drive yet, we have to mount the drive. There is a link and we have to activate with a key, some key. But if you are already connect to the drive, you just continue. Okay, there is I have load the webs. Actually, this is the folder. You don't need to type this. Instead, you just locate your data. This is the model that I have set before. Here and I just activate here. You just click and there is a copy pad here. So you just delete and it must be directly to your Google Drive. Yeah. So and then after loading the web, you have to compile. Okay. Actually, I have to delete this. Okay. And this is testing your train model. And the accuracy is 98%. And this is testing for the image. Okay, I want to use my first data. Oh, there is an unsuccess. Well, this is this is one. This is successful prediction, this is 2, and the prediction value is 2. Okay, we check, for example, 100. 100. Then we check. Prediction value 6, actual value 6. Okay, this is correct. Oh, okay, we try to 0. It means that 0 not a number, but index. This is actual value 7. Okay, we go. And then we predict from a new image. Okay. You can use notepad or something else to draw the what's it mean the handwriting. And for example, we use black because black is 0 and white is 255, so I have to invert the color here. For example, what is 4? For example, I want to draw 4. Okay, I have to save with the name 4. GPG file located in pictures. Okay, and then we back to our collab. And then we have to use a function called load image. This is actually pre-processing an image from anything, any pixel value to 28 by 28. And then we reset using a standard TensorFlow. There is a number here. And this is the dimension. And then we add the file that we have created for. Okay, here. Make sure that you this save to this file. Oh, I have to refresh. 4, okay. And then we create to the metric file name, and then there is an actual number. Okay, we type 4 and we just enter. Okay, the predict value is 4. So this is the successful prediction. Okay, we just another image. For example, I have upload 9. Sembilan in Indonesia, okay. And we run 9, enter, and this is a successful prediction. Okay, we try another. For example, 8. Sorry, 3 maybe. Okay. We upload again in our collab. And we predict Okay, I think it is the model is good enough with the 98 accuracy here, only 0.02 error percentage. Okay, I think enough. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.